Hello, Mr. Orr, literary lecturer in metallurgy. I'm a scientist. I have been to the university to get drunk with the old wine of the dead letters, desiring not to be new. That means these university professors cannot think logically. They just read the books, this professor said, that professor said, but themselves they don't know. They can't think logically. So they are super blind. The person who can think logically, he is not blind. And they are the person who are illiterate, shepherds, the farmers. That's why the good news of the birth of Jesus was broken to the shepherd and also the farmers at Cana, where Jesus prepared the new wine for them, and they appreciated it. While in the temple, oh, they don't want to know him. They want darkness and no light, so they can keep on fleecing people under the cover of the dead letters of the holy books. That's what they do in the churches and in Sikh Gurdwara, temples and everywhere. The priest is greedy. He is working for money, not for God. So what can you learn from him? Nothing. That's why you have sectarian rights. Now here is a nice passage come, which is Matthew 13, verse 18 to 23. Holy Gospel of our Supernatural Father, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc., delivered by the first anointed Christ, which in my native Punjabi language we call Satguru Jesus. Sat means the Gospel truth, Guru means who teaches you. Remember that this is the time of Christ. And Christ represents Father. Christ is the Son of the Most High. So he represents Father. So when he teaches us, then it is the God who is teaching us. And he doesn't make blind following. He himself is solitary. He makes his laborers solitary. We are no disciples. The root of the word disciple is discipline, which the rabbi disciplined by teaching the moral of Moses. They had disciples, but not Christ Jesus. So there are a lot of corruptions done by the Messianic Jews. And Messianic Jews, they are the legacy of those temple priests. Remember the last parable Jesus delivered in the temple was about the wine press. Wine is the old wine, which is the moral laws that were created by the temple. And they were corrupting them. Prophets came to tell them, to rebuke them. And they maltreated them, they killed them. They killed one Zakria in the temple itself, who was like John the Baptist, prophet Elijah. So John the Baptist dared not enter the temple. So he kept out into the wilderness to face the hypocrites. Then the master, Lord of Sabbath, Christ Jesus, he went to the temple to face them. The temple was under Menorah, Sabbath, and he was the Lord of the Sabbath, greater than the prophets. Much more you can learn through discussions and logical reasoning. There's nothing that will be hidden if you can think logically. Okay, Satguru Jesus, of the highest living God, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, same thing, that dwells within thee, within his most beautiful living temple. This is the most beautiful living temple of God, created by the greatest artist, Daniel Potter, the Lord of the nature, Yahweh, Brahma, Khuda. That is Daniel's, because this, without soul, this is dead. The soul comes from our supernatural Father, and Elohim Allah Parbrahm, that is invisible God. And so the soul is invisible in us. It is the property of our supernatural Father. The soul in us, it represents our supernatural Father. That's why we hate none in Christ Jesus. We love all 100%. And that is why we have love called agape. Under arrows, you love your own, you hate the others. You could be racist, but not in Christianity. If you are a racist in Christianity, then you are son of Satan, and nothing to do with God. So, highest living God, created by the greatest artist, Daniel Potter, the Lord of the nature, Yahweh, Brahma, Khuda, etc. And it is called Har Mandir. Har means God, Mandir means temple. Or Emmanuel, because God lives in his temple as you live in your house. And so the God lives in his house, which is this one. And it will be worshipped in truth and in spirit. So according to Saint Matthew 13, verse 18 to 23. So it's the parable of the sower, you know, which Jesus explained. So Jesus said to his twice born laborers, and not the once born disciples of the rabbis, which the Messianic Jews created. Because when you are disciples, you have to need a priest. And that is what these Messianic Jews, they put on dog collar and robes, and they become the priest. And they have disciples, as they were in the temple. They were good for nothing else but do the job of a priest. Not the disciple of the, and not the firstborn disciple of the rabbis. Their intake was natural boys. So here then the parable of sower, the seed, his word, sown on the paths, footpaths. Footpaths are there, you know, not even grass grows there. So that means seed is lying on the surface and not under the soil, not buried in the soil at all. They are the once-born people like Peter and these university theologians. They are the same. They are incapable of understanding the gospel. They can reproduce what Jesus said, or they read it from the books here and there, but they cannot interpret it, or cannot think logically. University theologians who are incapable of logical reasoning, but play with the dead letters. That's why Jesus said, let the dead bury their dead. And these are the super dead, you know, university professors. So worse than those rabbis from the yoke of which Jesus set us free. So if the one who hears the word of the royal kingdom of God within your own heart without understanding it as the seed is on the footpath uncovered with soil full of ego. So seed is on the display of the mental peace uncovered in the soil. So only when the soil goes on top of the seed, then it will, the plant will come up. So in ego, he doesn't want to be covered. He wants to keep his head over. So in ego, you know, the seed is not covered, and so are the university professors, full of ego. I go to Oxford University, and I'm a lecturer in metallurgy, and they just told me that you can't come to our seminars unless you have an MA or PhD in theology. So that is what they told me. And I laughed at them. I called them super donkeys carrying holy books. Then they retorted, our duty is to teach the dead letters of the Old and the New Testament. The interpretation is up to the student. They are right, you know, but they agree. They are the super donkeys carrying holy books. Very interesting. If you are witty, is the one who received the word of the royal kingdom of God. As they read in the books and other things, they find it, old scripture, within your own heart, without understanding it, as the seed is only on a footpath, uncovered, with soil, full of ego, that I'm PhD, I'm doctor, this and that, you know. And the evil one comes and steals away. They can, evil one means that the one who put on a dog collar and put on a robe to tell people that I am a man of God. He is not working for God. He is working for money. He is turning stones into bread. Stones means simple-minded people, devoted. And they turn them into bread. There are corpses. Remember, corpses mean dead people in letters, Bible, reading Bible day and night without understanding, dead in letters. So vultures mean the clever people. They put on robe, they put on dog collar, and these simple-minded people will buy them a car, buy them a house, and make him comfortable. They themselves live miserable. They themselves may not have two square meals. But that dog or a priest must be fed nicely. And he also is immoral. You know that in the beginning they were bastard born of the bishops and priests. And so were they immoral, you know. So they fulfilled Matthew 12, verse 43 to 45. Many things you will learn. Full of ego. And the evil one comes and steals away what was sown in his heart. Or he remembered what Jesus said truthfully. So he would represent, you know, truthfully as Peter was doing. Peter is a typical example of the firstborn. So Peter will tell truth as if whatever he saw. That is why he was given the key to the kingdom of heaven and hell. And he killed Ananias and Sapphira, two blasphemers. The seed sown on rocky ground, the twice-born, psychic, loving Mammon than God, evil-spirited, twice-born, as Judas Iscariot was. And those hireling, and these hireling so-called priests in the churches, they are also of the same order as Judas Iscariot, because they steal money from the church purse as salary. And same what Judas Iscariot was doing, stealing money from the purse he was holding. And that's why our Last Supper, before Jesus baptized them, the rest of the 11, he threw Judas Iscariot out because he was a thief. And so these so-called priests in the churches, they are thieves of the same order as Judas Iscariot, and they cannot be, they should not be in the churches. The church is to be governed by a person who is honest, working for God and not taking any money. The church, you have to give money to the church, not take money out of the church. Just opposite what the rabbis were doing. What applies to flesh, the opposite to spirit. St. Paul has stressed that also, you know. Sorry, Mammon, and not God, is the one who hears the word and receives it at once with joy. With joy, as you can see on the rocky soil when the plants come up with the little soil on it, and they are come up quick, but when the sunshine comes, then they wither away. But when you pray in the presence of God, they cannot understand. That's why in the presence of God, Judas Iscariot was thrown out of the wedding banquet, which Jesus did, into the darkness. But he has no root and lasts only for a time. That means they don't give the company as Judas Iscariot. He left Jesus when he was thrown out of the company of the 12, and he went to his own fold, which was the church, which was the temple priest, and he went to them, and he got money from them, Mammon, that he was, that's what he loved. For the sake of Mammon, he got his Christ Jesus caught. Because by that time, the laborers of Jesus were so proficient that the stranger come to know who is the real Christ, they would not know him. That is why they have to hire Judas Iscariot to catch the real Christ Jesus. So, examples are these hireling, dog-collared priests created by the Messianic Jews, who were the temple priests, the husbandmen of the winepress that created the old wine moral laws, but corrupting them. Prophets were sent and they beat them with all this. When some tribulations or persecution comes because of the word, he immediately falls away, as Judas Iscariot did when the temple priest wanted to kill Jesus. He left the company of Jesus and joined with them, with his own type, the chief money worker, as the dog of the priest was, same as Judas Iscariot. The seed sown among thorns. Thorns mean the worldly attraction. You see sometimes the shopkeeper, they open the shop early in the morning, 6 o'clock or 8 o'clock, and they close at 10. And they go home, they just eat the food and sleep. What time they are left for pondering over his word? No time. So they are clever because they are doing business. They are twice more doing business. But they have no time for God. 100% devoted to Mammon. And they bear 0% fruit. See, among thorns, worldly affairs, social, economical, and political affairs, three kind of on left and three on the right of the menorah, is the one who hears the word, but then worldly anxiety and the lure of riches, because he's clever, you know, he's not simple-minded person. He's twice more clever, like Judas Iscariot. But we call them psychic. The once born are called helic. And the twice born seem to serve God are called pneumatic. So the psychic, you know, they go for money. And the politicians are number one psychic. Whatever comes from their mouth is sugar-coated sermon. They won't spin the gospel to be bitter. And so much so that some of these media like YouTube and other people, when you spin the gospel to, which is bitter, they give you a strike. They don't like it. So you have to be careful, you know. You see, among some thorns, worldly, is the one who hears the word, but then worldly, anxiety, and the lure of riches. Because he is clever and knows how to cheat the people. How to cheat the people. Choke the word. And it bears no fruit. So no fruit that the evil spirited people, they rather destroy the Christianity or anything adding to it. So they are opposite, you know, to, they are Antichrist. They are clever, you know. But the seeds sown on rich soil. Rich soil means which is free of weed or these social, medical or political affairs. That's why those people who joined Jesus, they went for wilderness. Wilderness means there's no secular work to be done. You eat root and other things. You don't come to the town to buy anything or like this. Rich soil is the one who hears the word and understands it, who indeed bears fruit and yield 100, 60, or 30%. Now these are the four, you know, 100% is those who left their houses, like the Peter told Jesus, we have left our family and other things, what shall we get? They got 100%. Even Peter was once more. Still he got the Holy Spirit with capital S at Pentecost. And the doctrine that 16 seem to serve God, they get 100%. All this is very easy, you know, and you just have to get a knowledge of Trinity. The Trinity I have put under my description, and it will be lost underneath, you know. And if you print that one, then you can understand all the theology. The Trinity in Christianity is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. It's the family of God. It's not Trinity. It's not Trinity. But the teacher tells them, you know, they make story, you know, and all that tri-union God and all that, you know, they tell him. It is not that. In the family of God, we have Father is, our Father is God, our Mother is the Holy Spirit, and we are the sons of the Most High, and all three of them, they are solitary. They are not bound to each other. It is the filial love, filial, philosophical love that binds them. And so store the love, which is the love of the family that binds them. Much more in my other videos. I wish people are interested, but there are hardly anyone, you know, you come across.